The InfoTrend EonStor GS family product is a unified storage system that integrates file level, block level, and cloud gateway into one single system. This video is separated into two parts. The first part will demonstrate how to establish a connection with cloud storage service providers, including setup of software and hardware for the EonStor GS storage system, and access settings for the Microsoft Azure. The second part is a hands-on operation on how to backup and recover data stored on the Microsoft Azure cloud. Let us start from the first part. Establishing a connection with the Microsoft Azure requires 5 steps. First, we need to synchronize the time and time zone on the machine. Start Eon 1 and open the settings menu. Enter system settings. Click on the time page. First, set the time zone. Time zone can be set to any zone, not necessarily where the machine is located. Choose and press the apply button. Next, we will set the time. After pressing the change button, a time setup menu will appear. Here you can enter network time server information to automatically synchronize time in the time zone, or do them manually. Press the apply button to complete time and time zone setup. Second, we need to make sure there is at least one iSCSI block level channel on the EonStor GS. Return to the settings page. Enter access settings. Make sure at least one iSCSI block level channel is connected. If you want to change the channel type, simply click on channel and press the Add button to change. The system will then restart. Next, we need to create a pool to connect with Microsoft Azure. Return to the settings page. Enter storage settings. Click to change to the pool page. Press the Create Pool button. For dual controller EonStor GS models, a menu will appear to inquire whether the pool is to be created with symmetric active-active or a symmetric active-active. Here we will demonstrate using a symmetric active-active. For Create Pool, we will demonstrate using a RAID 6 pool with 4 hard drives and assign it to controller A. We can see the pool 1 that we just created in the list. Now we need to acquire your Microsoft Azure user connection information, including account name and access key. After logging in Microsoft Azure, select Storage Account from the menu on the left. Click Add in the Storage Account page, and name your account. We will need to use this name later when operating GS connections. For account kind, here we will select Blob Storage. Other options can be configured according to your needs. After creating an account, click your account, select Access Key, and you will see two sets of keys. In the last step, we will demonstrate how to use the access key information we just acquired to connect the EonStor GS with Microsoft Azure and upload data. Start Eon 1 and open the settings menu. Enter backup and restore settings. Switch to the cloud page. After switching to the cloud provider tab, click Add to add a cloud service provider. Select the pool we just created from the pull down menu and choose Microsoft Azure Storage from Cloud Vendor. For endpoint and shared key, copy and paste account name we just configured and one access key. Press OK when you're done. EonStor GS has completed connection with Microsoft Azure only after connected is shown on the Eon One. After connection, we need to create a volume and map it to the server so the data can be stored to the local storage, then uploaded to cloud. Switch to the Volume tab and click Add to add a volume. Newly created volume will have Enable Cloud ticked by default. In order to demonstrate backup and restore for the next part, we will select Cache Mode Fully Cache here. Select Continue for cache period. We will directly map out the volume in this step. Tick Host LUM Mapping. After mapping out the volume, we can now see the hard drive space in server's computer management. The second part will demonstrate how to restore EonStor GS with data backed up on the cloud. We will transfer some data to the cloud integrated volume we just created, then shut down the power of EonStor GS to simulate a disaster, and finally use another EonStor GS to recover data backed up on the cloud. First, we will store some data in the disk we just mapped. As we set it to fully cache and cache period to continue, data in the volume will automatically be backed up to the Microsoft Azure. Turn off the power after completion to simulate a disaster. Start up Eon One interface of another EonStor GS. Open the settings page. Enter backup and restore settings. Change to the cloud page. Switch to the disaster recovery tab and click on Recover Now to start the data recovery process. Enter connection information of Microsoft Azure. Enter storage account name for endpoint and fill in the matching access key for this account. Press Get Bucket Information button after completion. Here we can see the bucket which previously uploaded data. Click Preview to see the backed up volume in this bucket. Press the arrow sign to see if this volume has an uploaded snapshot. Choose the bucket to restore and press Next. Next, we will set up a pool to store the restored data. Here we will demonstrate creating a new pool. For create pool, we will demonstrate using a RAID 6 pool with 4 hard drives and assign it to controller A. Then select the volume to be restored. Press OK after confirming the information is correct and the data restoration process will begin. The restored pool and volume can be seen after completion. The volume at this time will be shown as unmapped. Return to the settings page. Enter storage settings. Select volume in the volume page, then click Map to Host. Click Create to create LUN mapping. We will directly map out the volume in this step. Go to Computer Management in Server to turn the hard drive online. And we can see the data has been successfully restored.